low blood sugars, you know, they drive me crazy. But if somebody told me that in trade for never having a low blood sugar, I could do cartwheels 3 times a day while repeating the alphabet backwards, I would do it. I absolutely would, because they are so obnoxious. So I try to treat my lows in a way that doesn't make them even more obnoxious. When I'm having a low, just like everybody else, I want to eat everything in sight. I mean, literally, it's our brains telling us, feed me so that I don't die right now. Feed me. But if I let myself eat as much as my brain wanted me to eat every time I had a low, I would gain a lot of weight. I mean, imagine if you had one low every single day and you let yourself eat even, you know, 400 calories every time you had a low, that would add up over the course of a week. That would totally. And then, of course, there's the lovely roller coaster of you have a really bad low and you want to eat everything in sight. You eat a whole lot of carbs. And then 2 hours later, you're having a really bad high. And then you're not feeling good from that. And it's, you know, it's crazy. It's a horrible roller coaster. And I don't like to be on it. One rule I've set for myself to kind of stay away from that roller coaster is I have foods that I treat low blood sugars with. And they're not foods I particularly enjoy. I mean, I don't think they're disgusting, but I wouldn't eat them for any other reason except to treat a low blood sugar. So they're really like medicine. Dried pineapple, dried fruit, like, yeah, it tastes good, but it's not something I really want to eat on a regular basis. So I keep that for really bad lows because there's so much sugar in such a small amount. For the lesser intense lows, I like to use juice boxes because I am never going to be like, oh, I want to drink 10 juice boxes because that's so good. I'm not going to be tempted to overdo juice, right? I don't even like juice. I really don't. I think of juice as medicine. If instead I were to let myself use something like Ben & Jerry's ice cream to treat a low, there's no way I'm gonna not want to eat that whole thing of ice cream when my brain is like, feed me before I die. You know, it's just, it's a bad mix of two different things. My personal philosophy is that if I want ice cream, I can eat that ice cream at another time when my blood sugar is stable. Or I can treat my low with a juice box, wait till my brain has stopped screaming for food, and then enjoy the ice cream with the correct amount of insulin, bolusing, etc. So another rule I have is that if I'm low right before a meal, I will not use the meal to correct my low. Because then I'm going to eat way more food at that meal than I would have if I wasn't low in the first place, right? I mean, so instead, I treat the low with a juice box. I wait. I try to wait, you know, at least 10 minutes before eating. And then I have my meal. If I'm at a restaurant with friends and I'm having a low right then, I ask the waitress for an orange juice. I treat the low with an orange juice. Try to, like, tell my brain, okay, calm down. You got your sugar. You don't need more than that. Wait for my appetite to go back to normal. And then I enjoy my meal. I have juice boxes, tabs, raisins, dried fruit, things that don't quickly expire or make a huge mess. I mean, I have had a juice box explode on me once or twice, but you gotta be careful about that.